The Santa Rosa First Peoples community are now in the process of electing a new queen of the community after the unexpected passing of the late Queen Jennifer Cassar earlier this year. Chief of the First Peoples, Ricardo Bharath Hernandez, gives some background into the tradition.
Well, traditionally, the process is that the reigning queen has the first option to name a successor based on her observation of the women in the community and their ability for leadership and to carry on and so on. Now, if the queen passes, as in the case of the last queen, without having the opportunity to do that, then obviously we have to have something like an election where the community is called together and we ask for nomination. And then if there are more than one name to be considered, then possibly an election.
As the role of the queen has diminished somewhat, but is still quite important for the unity of the First Peoples.
It's still important because, I mean, we carry on the tradition, but at one time in the earlier years, such as in the early 1900s, very important because the role of the chief died gradually because of the mission and the authority of the priest who was in charge of the mission. And so the queen now was seen as the main figure and as the leader of the community, mainly with the responsibility for ensuring the Santa Rosa festival, because although it is a Catholic feast and a religious festival, it was the only festival that replaced all the festivals that the indigenous peoples would have had before.
Mr. Hernandez explained who will be considered for the important role.
Usually, the candidate would be selected from among the active membership of the community. But if for some reason the membership feels that there is no one among them suitable for the role, then they can nominate someone who is a descendant of the First Peoples but not necessarily active, and consideration will also be given to that person.